When it comes to NHL defensemen, there are always a ton of names that you would expect to dominate the score sheet. Guys like Brent Burns, Morgan Rielly, and Mark Giordano are dominating the defenseman score sheet, and expectedly so. But there is one player who's playing for the Chicago Blackhawks, who is also finding tremendous success that a lot of people most likely don't know about. In this video, we're going to be talking about Erik Gustafsson. Yeah, his name looks kind of like Eric Gudbranson, but it's not the same player. This right here is a 26-year-old Swede playing on the Chicago Blackhawks. He is currently first in Chicago Blackhawks defender points. In the 42 games that he has played thus far with Chicago, he has himself 26 points. Good enough with 8 goals and 18 assists. He is on pace for a 50-point season as a Chicago Blackhawks defender. As a team with only one 50-point player thus far, and other players who aren't necessarily scoring all too much either, it's interesting to note that the fourth best point producer on the team is indeed this NHL-deprived 26-year-old Swede. He's played a lot of games in the AHL so far, and he's played roughly a full season's worth of games for the NHL too. But this season is the season where he's been coming alive. In the last game that he played against the Calgary Flames, he got himself 2 points, 2 assists in the Chicago loss. He also had himself 26 minutes of time on ice. He's being heavily relied upon by the Chicago Blackhawks as a top D-man, and he's consistently put up 22-plus minutes a night over the past few games. Taking a look at his game log, Gustafsson is at a 6-game point streak with 8 points in those 6 games. Every single one of these games has him at over 21 minutes. However, while his game does look like that of one that could totally put points up on the board and could be relied upon as a top defender, Gustafsson isn't really all too good in his own zone. And that has been the number one thing that Blackhawks fans that have been on the internet have been complaining about, because his defensive zone coverage is just so poor. He makes up for it with his incredible offensive ability and production, but as a defender, he's not necessarily the cream of the crop. Gustafsson is a player who a lot of Chicago Blackhawks fans are looking at and saying he's probably going to get traded. He's probably going to get traded to a cup contending team for a draft pick or something, because Chicago is not necessarily in the position that they can say, win now. But they have themselves a piece that could certainly help a team win now if that is what they wanted to do. So despite the fact that Gustafsson has a better points per game than guys like Jared Spurgeon, Ryan McDonagh, Zach Werenski, and he has more points than guys like Oliver Ekman-Larsson and Jake Gardner, he's not necessarily going to be fetching a huge return now just because of his defensive coverage. It's just not good. He is being played a heck of a lot, though, and that's partly because the Chicago Blackhawks really love his output. He's first on the team in defender points. Second is Duncan Keith with 19 points. Then you got Brent Seabrook at 16 points and Henry Okiharju at 11 points. The points are scarce for the Chicago Blackhawks defenders. If you take a look at everybody outside of Gustafsson, there's not that much. As a result, you get yourself a player who is very important to the team's offensive production, but still leaves more to be desired on the back end. Gustafsson is 26, so he's not necessarily super, super young, but he's still got room to grow before he hits his prime age of 27, 28-ish. So as a team going forward, the Chicago Blackhawks might be looking towards trading Gustafsson to a contending team for something that could help themselves out in the long run, because they got guys like Patrick Kane still leading this team offensively, but they got guys coming up like Dylan Strome, like Alex DeBrincat, who is still really good today despite only being 21 years old. So the options at this point are quite limitless for the Chicago Blackhawks. Who knows? Maybe they keep Gustafsson. Maybe they keep him and use him towards a playoff run in the future, if that is so to be desired. He's got great offensive output, his defensive game is kinda bad, but overall, it balances itself out as a valuable NHL defender. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, plus, and trust I sang gaming, and bye.